joined by Ali Mortazavi from e-Therapeutics. Ali, nice to see you. How are you?
It's about Andrew. How are you? Nice to see you virtually. Usually I have to travel to East London, which takes me an hour there and back, but this is so simple.
Well, indeed it is. It's probably the future of doing these videos, and you and I will be doing more of them. But news this morning here, Ali, Galapagos, you're teaming up with these guys as a new collaboration. Just for those not too familiar, tell us a bit about them. Who are they?
So Galapagos are a large biotechnology company, very successful one, been through the whole process from a very small company to now an $11 billion company. You know, areas of expertise, disease area expertise are inflammation and fibrosis. So fibrosis is a key area for them. And that's, you know, the cornerstone of the collaboration.
The announcement's a little bit thin on the financials. What can you tell us?
Thin. You know, I think we have to sort of balance, competitive. We have to be careful with our pricing structure, not to be too public on it. And we wanted to, but at the same time, give a good indication to people at the quantum. So I think what I can say is last reported net cash was circa sort of 5 million. And we used the word material to that to try and give a flavor.
So what are we talking here? Sort of hundreds of thousands or a little bit more?
Certainly not anywhere near the hundreds of thousands. No, I think that's a good compromise with material and 5 million, and not the hundreds of thousands.
Hmm. Well, using this platform, Ali, how many of these types of deals do you reckon you can do?
So the platform is very flexible, very modular, very I think for us it really is a question of scalability. You know, this project has got a sort of, if you like, a Gantt chart of, say, 9 months from inception to the end. And you know, we think a key goal for us is to do multiple projects in 1 year, and also to improve the timelines and the costs and the efficiency of the whole informatics process, if you like.
As far as the arrangement, what will e-Therapeutics be responsible for doing with Galapagos?
So yeah, I mean, in terms of sort of going back to sort of scalability and starting from there, Galapagos have chosen a particular mechanism or pathway they're interested in fibrosis. But obviously, there are many, many mechanisms and pathways and disease biology interests areas of interest within fibrosis. So you know, we have given them exclusivity on that particular disease area of interest, but you know, we're not restricted in any way in other potential areas of interest in fibrosis. And actually, we're not really limited by any disease area. So, for example, we have collaborations with Novo Nordisk in diabetes, as an example. But, a very high-level way of thinking about it is the platform can be asked any biological question in any disease area. So, you know, we're in CNS with MSD, we're in diabetes with Novo, and now fibrosis with Galapagos. So, you know, showing you the kind of diversity and the size and quantum of sort of people that are sort of entering into the world of sort of computational biology.
Of course, you've got your own drug discovery platform. You've added RNAi. What's the rationale there, and how does this fit into that?
So, yeah, I mean, RNAi, in no particular order, I think first and foremost, it's a highly specialist area. So obviously I've got a long background in that area. And we've recently hired a chief business officer who's worked at Silence, and especially in the same area. So, you know, I think it's an area that's difficult to come by in terms of expertise, especially in the UK. And the next level really is that, there have been two drug approvals in the space recently, and a takeover of the medicines company by Novartis for a very big number, I think something like $11 billion. So there's a lot of interest in terms of very early deal flow, platform deal flows. And going forward, really the final glue for me was that I think we can use the e-Therapeutics informatics platform. So I think where RNAi has got a problem is finding novel and interesting targets. I think we can use our platform to generate in-house targets, which we can then use the IP and the technology of what we call the liver targeted RNAi therapies. So yeah, it's a sort of two-pronged approach, if you like.
And just back to the announcement this morning, Ali, did you say in the announcement when you'd expect to see some of the upfronts or the milestone payments?
Again, I want to be careful on those exact specifics, but you know, I think you know the structure of these announcements. You know, in the detail, it's what we call our NDD product. They always have the same kind of format that a biological process or question is asked. It goes through what's called an informatics process, where we generate the informatics, and then, but ultimately, in the end, we really do ship physical synthesized compounds, something in the region of 1,000 small molecule, 200 to 1,000 small molecule compounds to a partner like Galapagos. They will then test those compounds in their screening assays. And if those compounds are shown to be active and altering a phenotype, then they make a decision to whether to take that compound into preclinical or clinical development. And that's when the milestones and potential royalties can kick in. So, you know, an element of upfront and an element of back-end optionality. So you can see that it's potentially scalable to a very good degree.
And given this collaboration here, plus your recent other deals, do you feel that you've got some good momentum behind the business now?
I think there's been, I'm kind of surprised even before I joined the company at the business development prospects. There's some very large companies who are interested in this space. Clearly, the more of these types of transactions that we do, the more validation we get of our platform. And I think the whole area of computational biology and being able to, you know, look at certain areas informatically, I still think you have to combine what we say a wet lab outcome with information. I don't think there's any way for anybody to really, using machine learning or AI, really just do everything in a computer. So I think what our partners like is the combined approach. So we bring informatics, but we apply it in a real world scenario where you synthesize compounds or you do wet lab tests. I think without that, the informatics alone will struggle to get these types of partnerships.
Ali, good to see you. Thanks for your time.
No problem at all. Okay, see you soon.